Jordan did it because he loved it.
Well, LeBron is number two in the league in scoring, but they're losing. So what does it matter if you're leading in scoring? It's a team sport.
Tough, man. Boxing's tough.
Yes, your dad always tells me you gotta be disciplined. But most fighters, Robert, most fighters are not.
Probably the most important thing is the discipline.
It's not easy.
It's tough, man. It's tough. We've had some very, very talented fighters, but with no discipline, they ain't going nowhere. They ain't going nowhere.
I've seen them come and go, very talented. It's sad because God gives you a gift, a talent, and you take it like it's normal. I think consistency beats talent if talent doesn't work hard, right?
100%.
The saying is hard work beats talent if talent. You used to have that at your gym, right? Hard work beats talent if talent. And it said a quote by Napoleon. I don't think Napoleon said it.
if talent doesn't work hard, it's true. We just talked about it. When people say, Spence is too skillful for Virgil, or Boots Ennis is too skillful. You never know inside the ring after the 10th round, 8th round, 9th round, 10th round. You never know how they're going to react. And we do know how Virgil is because I had him.
He's a very hard worker. Yep.
Yeah.
By the way, if Manny Pacquiao becomes president, how cool would that be, Robert?
He will. He is.
I hope so. He's a great person. He cares about his people.
Everybody loves him.
Listen, I've been around him where he gives homeless money left and right.
It would be nice to have Mexico one of those presidents like that because they would do good. Everybody.
You don't like the current president?
For the past 100 years, all they do is rob Mexico.
Who's your favorite president?
Mexico is so powerful or it's got so much fucking that... 100 years and they still haven't finished it. They still haven't finished robbing it. That means it's fucking, it could be one of the most powerful countries in the world. Like, see?
Those are not coming.
100 years and they still can't finish it.
Vicente Fox, who is your favorite president? Peña Nieto?
Calderon.
Why do you like him?
I don't know, that people just,
Is they're politicians.
Yeah.
Is he the current president?
No, the current president is AMLO.
He's the one who's like a socialist. He's the one who says, don't use a plane, all that stuff, right?
But it's, my dad really likes that guy. Because what he says on fucking his Tuesday show.
But that, he maybe just be a good speaker.
But hey, maybe he's just a good, and my dad believes all that. But there's a lot of complaints. People that live there, everybody complains about him.
So who would you want to see president? Which athlete?
Maybe Canelo. Because he doesn't need money. Canelo, like Pacquiao was being president for the Philippines. Maybe Canelo, because Canelo,
he likes
not
people.
Go rob the and country.
Listen,
he's gonna build so the country could be powerful.
It's maybe funny you Canelo. Say that, Robert, because he owns like 90, 100 gas stations.
Yeah.
He cares about people.
Canelo.
He donates a lot to children
maybe
and
Canelo, because he will try to get the country to become powerful the way it should be.
I think he would be a great president. Because he came from humble beginnings, so he knows.
He doesn't need money. He's not, he's not going to be involved with the cartels. He's not going to be snorting coke. You know what I mean? So maybe Canelo would be the good one for, back out to the Philippines. Maybe Canelo to Mexico.
Robert, you've had fighters come and go. Eddie Reynoso, it's part of the business. It's normal. I think it's normal in boxing. Nobody stays with you forever.
Of course, it's part of boxing, man.
I mean, you were the closest guy on the planet to Brandon. You were like family, you were like brothers. But even he moved to other training because you said, I don't want to train you.
Yeah.
It happens, it's part of boxing.
It happens, part of boxing.
So people sometimes will criticize the trainer or criticize the fighter, but it's normal in this business.
Yeah, you were right about Brandon. When I said, all right, go ahead. No. But I didn't really want him to do it anymore. But then he kept pushing that he wanted to push to do it a little more. So I was part of it pretty much to protect him. You know what I mean? To pick the right fight, the fight that are not gonna kill him.
But that's when his worst loss came, when afterwards, right? But hey, listen, it's a sport that if you stay in too long, you will get caught. Like if Roy Jones retired when he was pound for pound, forever we talk about him as the best fighter ever. He stayed longer, he made money, but I think it hurts him in the long run.
It hurt him more in the long run.
Because he never got hurt in a fight, never got stopped.
The fucker was silent.
James Toney, up to like last year, was never really stopped in a fight. Or, you know, never dropped. Shane Mosley never dropped ever till he fought in Australia.
Why do they still fight when...
The money, Robert.
Yeah, Elie, okay, yeah, the money. You just said it, the money, but in their prime, they blew $20 million. What makes you think the money, $1 million or $800,000, is going to save you?
Not save you, but I'll give you an example. There's an actor in Hollywood that's probably worth $800 million, okay? Legit. I got a call this week from someone who says, does he want to sit down and sign autographs and we'll pay him $100,000? And I told him there's no way he would do it. Like, he's up here. Guess what he said? Oh, absolutely, yes.
For the money?
Yeah. People would do stuff. They asked a billionaire, how much is enough money? He said one more dollar. So maybe in their head, they still think they can win.
Like Mayweather.
Yeah.
You know, some people could think, you know, he's worth $1 billion already. Why is he going to go fight that little... guy, he's gonna fire
money shoes or whatever,
or whatever.
Yeah,
when he's worth $1 billion, that's kind of actually, you know, fight just for them in a little fucking helicopter landing where only that dude's family gonna be there. So
yep.
I paid me with it. So it's kind of,
well, they announced it that was gonna happen.
But it's not around.
No.
Okay.
They said February, Floyd's week.
Okay,
weekend.
But I mean, okay, but still, if he agreed or you know,
they were talking about
like,
it. Yeah,
why? If he's worth $1 billion, why is he gonna go get paid $5-6 or whatever? Just cause that giving that man power, no, I have Mayweather here fighting my son. That's the only reason that guy was doing it for. Right? Say, yeah. Oh, my son fought Mayweather. And Mayweather was actually, you know, he wants money. That's good. That's fucking good for him. He's made a lot of it.
Yeah.
But at that point, does he really need $8 million more when he's worth $1 billion?
No, probably not. He doesn't need it.
Right. So that actor you're saying, for $100,000, maybe he just wanted to be around his fans.
No, he doesn't. He doesn't want to do anything. Because I know, like, so, he likes his privacy. He doesn't like to be bothered.
Okay,
but
so then for $100,000?
But I'm saying he's worth $800,000.
Maybe he donated the money.
I just think it's hey, it pays, I'll do it. If it's free, I wouldn't do it.
I guess so.
But, you know, we're all different. But you ask me why fighters still fight? Because they get their biggest paydays when they have the reputation and the resume. They're offered $500,000, $1 million, $1.5 million for a fight when they're not making money. What do most fighters do when they retire, Robert? Most fighters?
They have to go find a job. They do drugs.
Well, let's say, okay, but they can have a job and
they
do drugs.
They become drunks.
Okay, alcohol, drugs, and jobs. So why not go get paid before you have to get a job? Because having a job sucks. Nobody wants to wake up 7 in the morning, come home at 7 at night every day. It's not fun.
But look.
Art, do you ever have a day job? Did you ever have a day job? Did you love it? You hated it? You kept looking at the clock, when is the day over? Every minute felt like a month, right? Chepe, you ever have a day job?
I had a night job.
What was it?
A bakery.
Did you like it?
Fuck no.
You see? So how do you think a fighter that was a star that people cheered for? What did Frank the Cook tell you? I'm a celebrity. How can I get a job? Yeah. And he's not even... But,
the thing is that
but he's not even...
There's fighters
that's
that,
what I'm saying.
That's why they end up drinking or drugs, because they don't want to work.
But see, they had money.
The main thing is, the thing is that, you know, Josito thinks different, but most of the other kids, they think they already made it because they're going to turn pro.
They're on TV.
Or because they're, no, fucking, even though you're boxing, keep doing those classes online. Right now, everything's online.
Right.
So keep doing classes online. Look, okay.
Tax deduction
anyway.
Or
how talented, Chepe, how fucking talented is Raymond Morataya?
Super talented. One of
the
best
talented fighters in our gym, right?
Biggest secret in boxing, I would say.
One of the most talented
legit
fighters in our gym. Even his brother,
yep.
His little brother, his older brother, Gabriel, they're also
super
very talented.
Too.
He's also very talented. But if you talk to Raymond, when he's not in the gym, he's
studying.
He's actually already getting his master's.
Yeah.
They're still in school.
That's
and
true.
Because his mom pushes him to keep doing. This guy should be doing something. All these guys should be doing that.
You're right.
Taking classes, college classes. If, you know.
Getting a degree or getting a trade.
A lot of them actually drop out of high school thinking, I'm going to be a world champion. Even if you're a world champion, doesn't fucking make you, a million set for life.
I know world champions that have won major titles and made $75,000.
Exactly.
You know, Osito, what's the most money a fighter can make when they're fighting?
You're a world champion, you could be defending your title for $30,000.
That's it?
It's happened.
Mickey Bay for $70,000, right? That's all he got paid, if I'm not mistaken.
I heard that show that Barrera and Morales has.
Barrera made 150 in the fucking in the second fight against Morales.
You're serious?
150.
What happened to all the money? What was the budget?
You know
what? Someone else took the money.
Okay, whatever. Sure. He made 150.
That's nothing. Barrera.
Barrera. That's what Barrera says. He never. No, he's okay because he had a lot of.
He
fight.
Came from a family.
But he never. He was and he studied also. He also studied. I understand that he's a very smart person. That they said he was probably an attorney or something. I've heard something like that. He's smart, so that's why he's making a good living. But from his paydays in boxing, probably because he says, I've never seen the $1 million paydays. He says that he never really, like others, you know what I mean? So.
Well, look, Robert, what's the craziest thing you bought when you were a fighter and you got paid?
I was stupid then, you know, probably bought my fucking Navigator.
You wouldn't do it again today?
Yeah, probably, if I know I'm making more than that, a lot more than that. But then, if you're making $200,000, and you're gonna go spend $100,000 on a car? You're fucking stupid.
Osito, what's the most money you spent after getting paid?
I did that.
What's the craziest thing you spent money on?
I can't think of anything.
But I was the first one with a Navigator in Oxnard.
And then you gave it to Donald.
And then I gave it to Donald.
That was a nice car.
Hey, but that was the second Navigator. See, that was another stupid thing to do. I had my first Navigator for like a few years. And then comes the new one, it's fucking nice, and I go trade
it
for the new one. Fucking stupid. Fucking stupid. Honestly.
Well, stupid. Yes and no, because if you get one car and it's a tax deduction and it's for work, yeah, it could work.
Stupid.
But $100,000?
If you're making $2-3 million, yeah, buy yourself a Navigator.
What about just going to the dealership and say, I'll cut you a deal? I'll sponsor me, I'll put your logo on the thing? Or,
no, it doesn't always work like that. Very few can get away with that.
You know what Shaq told me once? You know what Shaquille O'Neal told me once? Girls are like cars. I always get, I never pay. But he paid.
Nah, it's tough, man. That's why I'm telling you, so many kids, they grow up boxing, and they think that's going to be...
It's very hard to make it. Very few make money.
And even those that have made it, there's fighters that, you know, Tyson blew $300 million.
James Toney, a lot of times.
James Toney, others that end up broke.
Nobody educates the fighters. Nobody ever says, you know what? I'm with the sanctioning body. I'm with the promotion. I'm with the commission. We're giving you this check, but no, like, this is what you're supposed to do with it. They don't even tell you to pay taxes. Do you have anybody in the gym that forgot to pay their taxes ever?
I think most of them probably never pay their taxes.
So what do they do?
They fucking have to, I don't know.
They're gonna get penalized.
I don't know. It's tough, man.
Yeah, but at least you're telling your fighters. At least they're hearing it from you.
Yeah, but that doesn't mean they're gonna do it.
Panterita, are you listening to this conversation? What are you gonna do with your first paycheck? First time you make $250,000, what are you doing with it?
I don't know, but just not spend it crazy.
You know, 40 goes to the IRS.
Okay, so you have 210, you know, 40, then 10% to your coach, 10% to your coach. Your management, you have a manager?
Yeah.
He gets another 20%, right? That's fair?
Whatever, I don't know.
Okay,
so you get up to 33.
Yeah, but that's a lot.
Well, managers do get 33.
I think that's a lot. No, 33 for management?
Yeah.
They could.
We all paid it. Shit, a lot of fighters that pay.
That's what Cameron Duncan took from you, 33?
No.
A lot of fighters Cameron takes 15, huh?
Yeah.
That's cool. That's fair.
That's very fair.
That's really good.
But a lot of fighters pay 30% to the management plus 10% to the.
That's 40% of your paycheck.
And then you hire a conditioning coach, and then you hire
a chef,
a guy that carries your bag and stuff like that. So you end up with half, and then you still have to pay taxes off that.
And then you buy a car, and it's all gone.
And it's all gone.
You have no money for gas. But the problem is with cars, lease it, because if you buy, let's say, even a Rolls Royce, after 1 year, the value goes down. If you buy a Maserati, it costs like $180,000, but a year later it's $27,000. Did you know that?
Six
it depreciates
ago,
like crazy.
I think we're going on 6 years already, or seven maybe. What? How long ago did we sign? What? Yeah, like 7 years ago.
Yeah.
We signed three fighters. They got a lot of money, bonus, signing bonus, and every month. And there was only one smart one that bought a house for the parents.
Wow.
The other ones have nothing left.
They burned it. They partied. Sad.
Just the way it is.
Yeah, but you should realize that money is not guaranteed. You may not make it again.
Yeah.
Hopefully you do.
Maybe they had a good time though.
They did have a good time.
That's true also.
What is it? The library on Tuesdays. They had a great time. But it's not worth it because
nah, it's true. In the long run,
no one's gonna remember the good times.
Yeah. Boxers, you don't need to have no education to box. So boxers, and they don't teach you in school.
You don't go to college.
Invest or nothing like
yeah,
that.
They
so they don't teach you how to invest or how to do taxes or nothing in school. So
how to open up a business? Yeah.
They teach you a bunch of like plants and history and stuff. They don't teach you nothing about life.
Like the way Neno's talking, but Neno grew up in turning pro under, you know, like my dad,
yep,
looking at Mikey.
Indian, yeah.
You know, and stuff like that. Neno has his house.
Yeah. You have a house?
Yeah.
Congratulations.
House.
Is it a trap house?
No,
a fucking badass house. Right
no, I'm joking, like full of girls. I meant,
like what, 5 minutes away?
I meant, is it full of girls all the time?
I live 5 minutes away from here.
Congratulations, it's a great area, big yeah, lot.
Really good area.
You have horses and all that?
No, but it's half acre.
That's what I'm saying, that's huge. Congratulations.
Yeah, thanks.
I saw one room was a gym.
Yeah, a little bit, yep. Yeah, the first like little living room.
That's great that you bought a house. That's really cool.
Yeah.
Not, are you gonna buy a house one day? You look like you would waste all your money.
Nah.
I hope not.
Better not.
Nah, he has a lot of savings.
Have you gotten paid yet?
No, they still haven't made a lot of money. So what's saving $1,000 every fight? You know, but they gotta learn that the more bigger the fights are, the more money. You know, if you spend $4,000 in your first fight, If you fucking spend all 4,000, don't save nothing up, then if you make 4 million, you're gonna spend all 4 too. That was it? You gotta know that, okay, put some to the side, take care of maybe, yeah, help the mom, the parents sometimes. Yeah, you have to. But, you know, starting early, 4 rounds, 6 rounds, you don't make a lot of money, but to them it's a lot. And if they spend it all,
well,
then they're gonna be making $20,000, they're gonna spend it.
When I covered the NBA, there were players that made $15 million and $20 million, and when they see me now, they ask me for $20. How do you burn through $20 million? You know how? Because they told me we thought we were gonna get another contract. We never got it.
Never got it.
So when you make your $15-20 million, act like that's you're not making anymore. Invest, buy a property, pay it off,
yeah,
use it as a rental, have the money come in, right? Don't open up a record label. Don't open up a restaurant. That's always a bad investment.
Become a rapper.
Don't become a rapper.
It's actually good to open up a bunch of businesses and then use it as tax write-offs. All the businesses as tax write-offs, so you don't have to pay taxes at the end.
You watch, what's that movie with the Getty Center where they cut the pinky of the grandson?
More like laundry.
What's the name of that movie? The movie, Osito. No, there was a movie of the guy, the Getty Center movie. He was really smart. He never paid any taxes. He was a billionaire because he kept buying art. And if you buy art,
it's like rich people never pay taxes.
Yeah.
They know how to use money. Like,
well, you need to find the right tax person.
Really knew many people who had a lot of money, but like people who have a lot of money, they never pay taxes. It's like rich people never pay taxes. Donald Trump never paid taxes. You know? They know how to work the system.
Hey, did you see the study? Everybody said they want Donald Trump to be the president right now.
Yeah, everyone's saying that now.
Did you see that, Robert?
Everyone's
yeah.
Fucked by Biden.
Wouldn't you?
Well, he's better with the Russians. People are scared of him. They're not scared of Biden.
Huh?
They're not, nobody's scared of Biden.
Biden can't even read.
He needs his vitamins. You're out?
Yeah, I'm out.
When are you going back to see Bivol?
Friday.
Are you ready?
No, sir.
Go easy on him. He has a big fight. I didn't realize he's 22 already. That's crazy.
Getting old.
Yeah?
Shit, Bam was what, like 14 when he started coming in?
15.
I think Canelo's a favorite. It's not an easy fight.
He was outrunning Austin Dulé, Navarro.
Who did Austin Dulé just fight? Austin Dulé just fought someone.
He would go to the track and he would outrun a bunch of guys. It would always be Hector, Josh, and Bam leading.
Austin Dulé just fought someone and they stopped him. They knocked him out. Do you know who it was?
Did he fight Ryu? No.
Was it Ryu? Ryu's fighting.
Yeah, he's fighting on the pay per view.
Yeah, but it's what's his name? It's Francisco Vargas, right?
Oh, yeah, he's fighting Vargas, yeah.
He should win that one.
Yeah, Ryu should knock him out.
Yeah? He's fighting on Spence card, right? That's a good fight.
Yeah.
No, but Robert, it was a